Hello, this is Vicky. I am a little disappointed and dissatisfied at myself. I usually am able to figure things out, especially when I'm looking at videos and YouTube, and there are so many resources out there. So when we're following things and they seem to make sense and I'm following them to the letter and it still doesn't work, I'm feeling a little sad about that. So the only thing I can do is to go ahead and turn in what I have done and continue working on it so that I can master this, because I myself do believe that testing is a vital function of all software development. And I just wasn't aware of how inept I was going to be at it. So to start, right here is my code for my 2D shooter game that I did last week. I was able to look at what needed to be done. When you're using the Unity engine, what you do is you get the test runner. Called the test runner inside of Unity, where you go to Window, General, and you set up the test runner. When you set up the test runner, then you make tests and a test suite. And inside the test suite, there's also a script for the game assembly. So I was able to follow every bit of that to the letter. I was really excited that I was able to do that. And I was certain after numerous times of walking through this that it was going to work. So I did use the test runner. I did create the assembly under scripts. I did create the test suite. And now let's look at the code in my test suite. Here's my test suite code. This is the test that it's supposed to have in the game assembly that I was talking about that's required. Even though it says to use the in-unit framework, it was arrowing out on me, so I just commented it and left it there. Although I believe it should be there, so I will put it back in. And I created the public class of test suite, as the instructions say, and the private game object of game. All of my research says that game is what it's called because everything falls under game when you're testing a Unity game. And that under setup, public void setup, this is to create a new instance of the game for each test, because you want to start over at each new with a new instance at each test. But everything is nested under game. So I was able to do that. And this right here is to set up a new instance of the game object, upon every test. The game object, game object, and everything's under mono behavior, but I was unable to get that to work exactly right. And I instantiated the resources, loaded the game object, which came from prefabs in game. But game, this never was happy. It's never, nothing I did, small, lower cap, nothing made that happy. So I'm thinking that was one of my major errors right there, if someone could help. And in addition to setting up for every test, you have to tear down after every test so that you can start fresh. This is to delete and reset the code after each test so that when the next test runs, no artifacts will affect the test. That's perfectly clear. I totally understand that. The public void now is tear down. It deletes the game object after each test and creates a new game instance in setup afterwards. And this is the code, object.destroy. That worked. That was fine. The Unity test is an attribute which tells the compiler that this is a unit test. And it makes it appear in the test runner right here. It makes it appear, right here they are, in the test runner when the tests are run by using this attribute, Unity test. And the test that I wrote was to test that my targets actually appear. I programmed the game so that the targets appear in random locations every 2 seconds, and then if they don't get shot, then they disappear. So under my IEnumerator, I put that targets appear, and everything that I came up with said you have to use the game getSpawner so that it can spawn the target. It didn't like getSpawner. It was not accessible. Nothing I tried under GetSpawner worked. I would love some feedback on that. And to keep track of the initial position that my target was spawned at, this is my code. That seems to be fine. And to yield a return, all unity tests are coroutines. They all work together. So I added a time step to simulate the time before the target should disappear, because my programming said if the on mouse down didn't hover over the target after 2 seconds, it would disappear. So that was the code there. And this is the assertion step to make sure that it actually did happen, which would mean that my target was destroyed. Assert less, and there's the code. So it would move. And there's another unity test that the mouse down actually destroys the target. And again, the only thing that's really hurting me here is I can't find what to do about this get spawner. Every resource says to use that, and I'm not sure where I'm going wrong to make that not work. Like Christopher, I worked hours and hours. I was up almost all night last night because I was a little late getting this in because I had an unforeseen situation yesterday. Thank you, Professor Nick, for letting me work a little longer on this. Although, as you can see, it was to no avail. I was not successful. I'm very dissatisfied with that. I would love some feedback on what I'm actually doing wrong here, and maybe an example of how to walk through my games, my 2D shooter, because it is such a simple game with such simple code, to maybe help come up with a couple examples of how this code should look so that I can use that going forward. I'm sorry it wasn't any more successful than that. I welcome your feedback. Let's keep going. Let's do this. Vicky out.